IDEOGRAM AI and the art that you can create with it is going to work for someone generating it for free and fun, but also someone looking to monetize their art, looking to create passive income for themselves. We're going to be talking about several different prompts and what IDEOGRAM AI struggles with and what it succeeds with, and how to actually monetize these designs if you stick around to the end. Let's get started. Prompt one, Bohemian floral font style, mother of the gardens in quotations, typography is the style. So this is a prompt that's going to give you text-based design, but with floral elements, with leaf elements, and all of these turned out really, really good. Prompt two, potato vine plant as the font style and text, sourdough and chickens in quotation marks. So you can see that my prompts are very basic, but I do have magic prompt on. So magic prompt will come in and actually expand on these. And from there, again, this is another typography based design, and I'm using the elements that tie into the theme of the design as the font style. So sometimes you're gonna get some weird outputs like this that you can't really use. But three out of the four ended up looking really good. So that's prompt number two. Prompt number three, Aztec font style, don't look up, with UFOs hovering above a pyramid in the desert, designed for apparel and shirts. So as you'll notice, as a common theme, I'm telling it to design for apparel and for shirts because it's more likely to come back with an output that has a round-based design or a V-shaped design that looks amazing on t-shirts. This one, for example, would not look the best on a t-shirt. It wouldn't look bad. Something like this that has more of a tapered edge and that we can actually make the background transparent on is going to look a lot better. Prompt number four. Generate an image of a drone quadcopter landing on the moon, USA flag staked on the moon in the background, suitable design for a shirt illustration. So this is a very, very specific prompt. Sometimes I'm a little more vague, sometimes I'm more specific, and only some of these turned out with what we were actually looking for. This one, not so great. This one, not very good at all. This one wasn't terrible, but not really a great design for a t-shirt. But this one here, number two, was the winner. Definitely came out looking good. Prompt number five, a whimsical vintage illustration of Bigfoot wearing a fisherman's hat, sitting by the stream. He holds a fishing rod that has a line in the water. The background is a serene woodland scene, and it keeps going from there. This is a magic prompt that I actually copied and used as the main prompt. So this is something that I do if I get a close illustration to what I'm looking for. I'll just copy that magic prompt, paste it into the generate box up here at the top, and then generate from that prompt. Another thing that I like to do is actually read through it and then remove anything that may have caused it to be wrong the first time. So if it didn't get the text correct, or if the hands don't look right, or if it added random elements that I didn't ask for, you can always go back into that prompt and copy it and then change the parts that are incorrect and then regenerate with that correct prompt. Prompt number six, generate a design of a stegosaurus playing in fireworks, design suitable for a children's shirt illustration. So this one turned out pretty good. 4th of July is coming up soon. Works really well for that theme and for kids related apparel. Prompt number seven, a vintage illustration of a calm ferret sipping tea. The house is on fire in the background. The text grin and ferret is visible, suitable for a t-shirt. This is an illustration. So this is a play on words like grin and bear it, but instead it's grin and ferret. So I feel like this turned out amazing. Prompt number eight, a dinosaur driving a race car, a design suitable for a kid's shirt illustration. So as you can see, this one turned out all right. I don't know what's happening in this one, pretty weird. This one, again, the fans in the background don't quite look correct. So not all of these turned out awesome, but this one I felt looked pretty good. Prompt number nine, a black and gold celestial style design, clouds with yin yang koi fish, beautiful illustration. So this one I think was my favorite, would look really nice on something like a gaming mouse pad or a shower curtain. Really, honestly, a beautiful design. I think IDEOGRAM did really good with this one. Several different variations here, but if I had to pick one that was my favorite, I would choose this one. Here was one that I actually made for Easter. This is prompt number 10, a delightful and playful illustration of a rabbit driving a bright yellow excavator with the word excavator written in bold, vibrant typography. So if you want it to be typography, specify that. If you want it to have text, if you want it to be a certain color scheme or a certain feeling, you can talk about feelings. It doesn't have to be make it yellow. You could be make an exciting design. Make something that someone would find funny. You can talk about these different emotions and these different feelings. Obviously, this would not really be something that maybe an adult would wear, but it would be perfect for a kid's shirt around Easter. Here are some more examples of the excavator. These didn't turn out quite as good, so keep working with the generations if you're not happy with how they turned out. And a couple more. Prompt number 11, a cat walking away with the cat looking back. The text, you're gonna clean that up. And it's a funny design for a shirt. It's illustration and it's typography. Prompt number 12, the word dad spelled out with fishing rods, with each letter a fish hooked to one of the lines, typography. This one did not turn out good enough, in my opinion, to actually use for print on demand for e-commerce to try and sell it and make money. Sometimes the designs just aren't good enough and you have to move on, but it was an interesting concept to try and use something like a fishing rod to create text. This one doesn't look terrible, it's not bad. The text, ask me about dinosaurs, design for a kid's shirt, typography and illustration. So it's actually using in some of these designs the shape of the dinosaur to form the letter, but they're not really perfect. Some of these look like dinosaurs. Some of them look more like monsters. And this one here has a little bit more of a traditional feel to it. I don't know why one of them's on a bicycle, but he's looking like he's having a good time. Here's another generation for prompt 14 of how I refined the prompt for this style of design. A vibrant and playful kid shirt featuring an eye-catching typography. The text, ask me about dinosaurs, is written in bold, colorful letters with each letter shaped like a different prehistoric dinosaur, or the letter has scales and teeth. So I changed this prompt, the magic prompt that came back the first time, altered it to make it closer to what I'm wanting it to be, and this is what I put in for my prompt. So don't be afraid to actually expand on this magic prompt, copy it, and then go back up to the actual bar up here and create some new generations. Once you've gone through the prompt, fixed the things that you'd like to fix. Prompt number 15, the text, dad, grandpa, veteran, you can't scare me, with USA flag and jets flying in the background, illustration and typography. These came out really beautiful. I liked this last one here, and I love that it's a hand-drawn style. Again, you could take the magic prompt here and change some things about it, re-prompt and regenerate to get more art, but I liked how this looked the first time. Prompt number 16, a creative and humorous design for a shirt featuring a silhouetted man driving a tractor with the words, I'll be in my office, written in a casual, playful font. Tractors driving through a serene countryside with a vibrant sunset in the background. Prompt number 17, hide yourself, become the legend, Bigfoot, Sasquatch, and forest themed in typography. So really simple prompt, magic prompt expanded on it quite a bit. And so this would work well with a phone case, a shower curtain, something that is square, not so much with a t-shirt. Prompt number 18, generate a kawaii cute image of Sasquatch eating ramen noodles with a pair of twig chopsticks in the forest and make it a suitable design for a t-shirt and illustrated. So notice how when we specifically ask for it to be for a t-shirt, it often has a transparent background with some elements, having transparency behind them. It often has a outline behind it. And while it might not be perfect, it's definitely more suited for apparel and for t-shirts when we specify what we want it to be designed for. So be sure to include in your prompt what product you would like it to be best for. If you want it to be for a puzzle, specify that it will be designed for a puzzle, for a t-shirt, etc. Prompt number 19, a retro sunset background with the silhouette of Bigfoot walking across and the words, get lost. And before we talk about how to actually sell and monetize your skill of creating these prompts on IDEOGRAM, now that you know what prompts to use and how to better create designs, how do you actually monetize it and create income for yourself with these designs? We're going to talk about that here in just a second, but here's our prompt number 20, the text lemon on a pear, design suitable for a t-shirt, lemon writing on the back of a pear that has a guitar, both are laughing, typography and illustration. So most of my designs that are going onto t-shirts, that are going onto different products, are going to have an illustrated element, a typography element, or both. In this case, we have both. So when it comes to actually monetizing the art that you've created on IDEOGRAM, how do you do that sustainably? You obviously don't want to fill your garage up with sweatpants or t-shirts or ornaments or mugs. You want to use a fulfillment partner that can print these items as they sell for you. So if you're selling on Amazon, if you're selling on Etsy, if you have a Shopify store, those are three places I love to sell. You can connect directly with Printify, simply upload your AI designs to these different products, candles, phone cases. They really have almost everything you can imagine, even pet products, bento boxes, canvas art that goes on your wall. So you can explore and get lost in here, and it's free to create an account. And they're gonna ship these products out of the United States. They're gonna create them in the United States, and it's gonna go directly to your customer only after you've received a sale. So it costs you absolutely nothing until, for example, you sell a phone case, and you may have the phone case listed, for example, $19.95 or $24.95, but your price would be $11.03 plus $2.59 shipping. So you would keep the difference after selling each phone case. And it might not sound like much, but whenever you create a lot of AI designs, you establish a lot of real estate online on platforms like Etsy and Amazon and Walmart and eBay, you can eventually create a passive income stream for yourself where Printify is basically creating and shipping and printing these products. And all you really need to do is create the designs and then post and list products. So I hope you have an amazing rest of your day. Sign up for Printify. There is a link to sign up for free below in the description. You can also sign up for the free Discord group where we talk about how to succeed using AI and e-commerce and other ways to succeed with AI. And also, if you'd like one-on-one coaching, there's a link for that. If you want to join the free Facebook group, all of those links are in the description below. Hope you have an amazing day. See you in the next video.